Hello, I'm Dr. Jimmy Douglas, and today's topic is HBA1c blood test, which gives the average blood glucose levels in the previous 8 to 12 weeks. When you eat food, it is digested in stomach and small intestine and is converted to glucose and enters the blood, where it is attached to hemoglobin in the red blood cells. It is an important test to assess the long-term glycemic control in diabetics, as it is directly related to risks for diabetic complications. Let's see what is HbA1c blood test and what is the procedure for the test. Before the test, this test is not affected by your recent meal intake, and you can even take the test after a meal, and there is no necessity to fast overnight for this test, and blood can be given for testing at any time of the day. The blood from the vein is collected in a sample collection vial, which is purple in color, containing EDTA. EDTA prevents clotting of blood in the tube. What is tested? Hb in HbA1c refers to hemoglobin. A1c is the subtype of adult hemoglobin. Majority of hemoglobin healthy adults is of A1c, and other hemoglobin variants are A1a, A1b, A1c and others. HbA1c means glycosylated hemoglobin, and also called as glycated hemoglobin, which means the sugar molecule is attached to hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is found in RBCs or red blood corpuscles, also called erythrocytes, in the blood. As HbA1c is circulated within red blood cells, whose lifespan is around 120 days, generally reflects the state of blood sugar in the preceding 8 to 12 weeks, thereby helping to assess glycemic control or to diagnose diabetes. Testing methods of HbA1c. It is tested by high performance liquid chromatography or HPLC method. In this method, less blood sample is required. It is precise, rapid, and takes around 20 minutes. Results and HbA1c normal range chart. The normal range of HbA1c is between 4% and 5.7%. Normal healthy adults have HbA1c below 5.7%. The values are represented in percentages. Normal is below 5.7%. In pre-diabetes, it's between 5.7 to 6.4. Diabetes, it is 6.5 or above. Here you can see in the chart, the percentages can be reported as estimated average glucose. How accurate are the test results? There is a possibility that the test results may not be accurate. Let's see the conditions. Conditions which decrease red blood cells' survival can falsely lower HbA1c levels, as we know that HbA1c is circulated within red blood cells or erythrocytes. Accuracy of HbA1c results are affected by hemoglobin variants, and in persons with hemoglobin F, low HbA1c values are seen. Acute blood loss and hemolytic anemia will show false lower HbA1c levels. Intravenous iron and erythropoietin therapy for anemia in chronic kidney disease, vitamin C and vitamin E can lower HbA1c levels. Conditions that increase erythrocyte survival or red blood cell survival can increase HbA1c levels, which are splenectomy and iron deficiency anemia. As we know that HbA1c is directly related to risks for diabetic complications, and complications were noted when HbA1c levels were above 7%. With every 1% increase in HbA1c levels, the risk of complication is 25% to 30%. For 7% to 8%, the risk of complication is 25% to 30%. 8% to 9%, 50% to 60%. For 10% or 11%, it is 100%. So to monitor it, we repeat it every 3 months. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.